Hey guys, today is Monday, October 8th. I am exactly 1 week post-op of my surgery. Sorry that I have not posted a vlog until now. It's been kind of a rough week. So I'm gonna talk about that a little bit and put some pictures and stuff in this vlog for you. So I had my surgery on October 1st, 2018. I went and stayed the night that Sunday because I had it in Belmont, Iowa, and that's about a two and a half hour drive from where I live in Newton. And I did not want to have to get up at 3 a.m. to have my surgery because I was first in line. So, I had to be ready by 5 a.m. I did not want to have to get up at 3 and drive. So I just stayed the night before. My husband and my mom went with me. And of course, I didn't sleep very well the night before. But I got up, showered, took all my jewelry out. I had to wash with that special soap the night before and the morning of. They put my IV in, got all prepped, talked to the surgeons. They took me down. I was a little nervous going down. I was like, oh my gosh, this is it. I can't back out. This is it. It's happening. I got a little nervous laying on the table. I was almost like, oh my gosh, wait, wait. But I didn't, I went through with it. So they put me to sleep, and my mom and husband waited in the cafeteria. And the surgeon said that it only took him a half an hour to remove my stomach, well, part of it. And I woke up the first time, probably about 10:30 or 11, and they took me upstairs in my room to recover. However, I do not do good with anesthesia, and I always wake up very like emotional, and it takes me a long time to come out of it. I didn't wake up like fully like stay awake until about 3 p.m. Which I could tell like scared my mom and husband a bit. My husband has never seen me be put under, so I know that was scary for him. There weren't any complications from my surgery. However, I did wake up a little bit in the recovery room around like 1, and I threw up a blood clot, which caused me to open up the glue on one of my incisions over here. The surgeon said that hasn't happened in years, but it wasn't anything super concerning. So, they stitched my incisions from the inside and then put glue over them. So I was bleeding out of this one for a bit, but it was okay. I got up, I started walking. I couldn't eat anything really. It was just kind of like ice chips and sugar-free Jolly Ranchers that whole day. And then, I was tolerating my pain meds. Then that next following night, so it had been early Tuesday morning, I woke up about 4 a.m. with severe stomach spasms. So I hit my nurse Light, and he said he had to take my vitals anyway, so he took my vitals before he gave me pain meds. However, my IV was in this hand. You can still see my little dot. He put the blood pressure cuff on this arm, and I don't know, it was really painful for my whole arm the rest of the night, and I was on and off sleep. And then lab came in, they tried to take blood out of this arm and they couldn't. So she's like, well, we're gonna shut your IV machine off and take blood out of this arm. And this was about 7 a.m. So she shut my machine off. Then the nurse came back in, turned it back on, and I was just like, okay. Then the lab came in, she's like, did you turn it back on? I was like, yeah. And she's like, well, it needs to be off. So they turned it off again. And then she came in and drew blood, and I'm like super bruised right there because they had to take blood out of the same spot because they couldn't find it anywhere else. Then he came back and turned my IV on. And at this point, I'm still hurting from the spasms, even from 4 a.m. Those meds didn't do anything for me. And all of a sudden, when he turns my IV on, I feel like every pump in my hand. And I'm like, this hurts. You need to shut it off. Come to find out, when he put that blood pressure cuff on my arm, he pretty much like blew my veins. So when he gave me those meds at 4 a.m., they didn't do anything. And so I hadn't had any meds from 8 p.m. Monday until 8 a.m. Tuesday. So I was in a lot of pain that morning, and, you know, they were wanting me to be up and walking, and I was like, look, everybody else had pain meds all night. Like, I need some time to kick this in. So I had, they ended up taking my IV out because I was supposed to go home that day, and just gave me pain meds orally. So I took the pain meds and I did fine. I took my shower, I walked, I kept down some broth and Jell-O and all that. So, I came home and I've been taking it slow. My incisions, I feel like, did get infected. In fact, I might post a couple pictures of those, and I might go ahead and show you guys. I have 6 on my stomach. They're doing a lot better. I ended up calling my doctor on Friday and telling him that I believe they're infected. With me being diabetic, like, that's too scary and something that shouldn't be messed with. So he did give me Augmentin and amoxicillin, and I have been taking that since Friday night, and I have to clean these 2 or 3 times a day. I feel like they're a lot better. I'm doing okay pain-wise. I don't have a lot of pain. I'm getting up and walking around really well. I have been for a few days. My main struggle is, like, the spasms, but it's weird because I get them without, like, eating anything. And then nausea. I've had some pretty bad nausea spells and some dizzy spells. I had a really bad day on Friday of dizzy, and then this morning I took a shower and I had to lay down for probably an hour afterwards just because I feel dizzy. I'm still kind of not feeling 100% right now, so I'm just taking it day by day, keeping on top of my medications. I drink protein shakes and Jell-O and sugar-free pudding, creamed soups. That's kind of my diet right now. I have an appointment today with my diabetes doctor, and then I have an appointment with Iowa weight loss specialists on Wednesday. So I will keep everybody updated. For now, that's my update. I'm going to post some before and after pictures and some pictures of when I was in the hospital. Any other questions, feel free to message me, and thank you for all those people who checked in on me and made sure that I was okay, and who prayed for me and sent me well wishes. So, thanks. See ya. I forgot to mention in my video, I am officially 23 pounds down. since I started, and I'm officially 15 pounds down since I left the hospital last Monday. So, what would happen if you say what you want?